Ah, welcome to the New World America, where the sky's the limit, literally. Pilgrims, pioneers, and Paul Revere, let's dive in. So it's 1492, and Christopher Columbus is sailing the ocean blue. He stumbles upon America, but guess what? He thinks he's in India. Awkward. Fast forward a bit, and it's the early 1600s. Jamestown, Virginia, John Smith arrives, and honestly, it's a hot mess. Rats, famine, and oh hey there, Pocahontas. But who knew? Tobacco would save the day. Suddenly, everyone wants a piece of the Jamestown action. Oh, and don't forget the Mayflower. Pilgrims dock at Plymouth Rock in 1620. You think they're prepared? Nope. Half die that first winter. Good thing Squanto and the Wampanoag tribe were there to teach them to grow corn. Thank you, fertilizer. The 13 colonies are shaping up, each doing its own thing. New York's a bustling trade hub, Pennsylvania's all brotherly love, and Georgia's a penal colony. Yep, the original Australia. British rule, no thank you. Tensions escalate over taxes like the Stamp Act. Colonists get mad, and Sam Adams says, let's make a scene. Boom. Boston Tea Party happens. The British are ticked off and impose the intolerable acts. It's going south real fast. Now we're in 1775, Lexington and Concord. Paul Revere shouts, the British are coming, and bang. The first shot gets fired. Who shot first? No one knows, but it's on. Americans get whooped initially, and George Washington thinks, how about guerrilla warfare? Genius. Washington knows it's all about morale. Christmas 1776, he pulls a Hail Mary and crosses the Delaware River to surprise the Hessians. The gambit pays off, and Americans start believing they can win. Molly Pitcher's reloading cannons at Monmouth, and it's getting intense. Let's talk alliances. The French are like, wait, you guys are fighting the British? Count us in. So at Yorktown, 1781, Washington and the French trap General Cornwallis. No way out, buddy. Cornwallis surrenders, and people from Philadelphia to Paris are dancing in the streets. But hang on, the drama's not over. Articles of Confederation, more like Articles of Confusion, they're too weak, and everyone agrees we need a do-over. Enter the Constitutional Convention of 1787. They're drafting, they're arguing. Hamilton and Jefferson throw down over a central bank, and finally, the US Constitution is born. But wait, now we've got growing pains. The country expands with the Louisiana Purchase, and Lewis and Clark are playing real-life Oregon Trail. Watch out for dysentery, folks. Don't forget the Alamo. Texans and Mexicans are at each other's throats, and Davy Crockett becomes a legend. We get Texas, but the Native Americans and Mexicans are going, this is our land, guys. Fast forward to the 1800s, and the steam engine is revving up. We're laying down railroads like there's no tomorrow. Industry booms, but so does slavery. A dark cloud is forming, and the country is about to tear itself apart. Abraham Lincoln steps onto the scene, and the nation is holding its breath. But let's pause here. In the next episode, we're diving deep into the Civil War, Reconstruction, and all the challenges that turned America into the powerhouse it is today. So stick around, hit that subscribe button, and let's take this roller coaster of American history up the next big climb.